Aaron, and I'm going to miss you so much. Midland isn't going to be the same without you. And neither will I. I knew it was going to be hard to read this part because I was crying while writing it. We love you, Aaron, and I hope you do great things at your new school. Before attempting to write this, I thought that graduation wasn't a big deal because I have another one for high school. I've now realized that it is important, at least to me, because of my classmates. Each of them have taught me new things that ultimately made me a better person. Being able to grow and mature with these young men and women behind me, or to the right of me, which I didn't know was happening, has been just a great pleasure. I love you guys. You're always one of the biggest highlights in my life. Thank you, classmates, teachers, and coaches, for helping me mature and getting me ready for school. I think that you all did a pretty great job.
Hello, everyone. I would like to thank some people in my life today. First off, I want to start with my immediate family. Dad, I thank you for keeping our family together. I also thank you for helping me with math and keeping me in the parking lot, helping me study for tests. Mom, you're always there, and even though you pester me, you always make my food, and I still love you, even though I always tell you to calm down. Now time to thank some personal items. Thank you, Duck Dynasty, for keeping me entertained, and thank you, Home Alone, for giving me good ideas for random people who come to my doorstep.
Award for academic achievement. And this goes to students that have maintained a B average throughout the entire school year, or they have shown a strong commitment to success. They should be proud of the work that they have put into this school year. There are three students that will be receiving the Presidential Award of Achievement. So I'll read off their names, and if they would come forward, and I will give you your certificate, those people. Are Gabrielle Carrera, Daniel Hickman, and Morgan Wickizer. So now I would like to recognize those students that will receive the Presidential Award of Excellence. And there are seven students that will be receiving this award. So please hold your applause so I can rattle off all of these names here. And if these students would come forward as I call your name to get your Presidential Award for Excellence, Aaron Harrell. Hold the applause, remember? Aaron Harrell, Andrew Homer, Priscilla Josiah, Brianna Nelson, Yahaira Olivas Moreno, Mason Piva, and Victoria Shelton. The next award. This award honors Mr. Keith Vollmer and his 41 years of service to Midland Adventist Academy. Yeah, we can clap for that. I'm not sure if he's here, but he is. Anyway, it honors him. It's presented by the Midland Alumni Association, and it recognizes the students who best display the qualities that Mr. Vollmer demonstrated in the classroom day after day. Specifically, the student must maintain a B average, no problem here, be involved in school activities, be a caring individual who shows compassion and friendship to his or her classmates, and exude the Midland spirit, be a person who best reflects what Midland is about. A $100 scholarship is awarded to an 8th grade graduate moving on to high school. And I'll say that this was a very tough one for me to choose. I could argue that most of the students in this class deserve this award, and I'm not just saying that to make everyone feel good. This truly is a very gifted class with a lot of talent and potential. However, after many sleepless nights, the decision has been made that this year's very deserving recipient of the Keith Vollmer Scholarship Award is Yahaira Olivas-Marino. This award goes to, as you know, the student with the top grades in the class. Again, this was another very close fight. There were three or four students who were battling it out, and I really hope that those that did not come in first place don't take it too hard, because you really have nothing to be upset about. You've worked hard, and just unfortunately, sometimes we don't always get a trophy for all of our hard work, but trust me, it was worth it, and I want to keep encouraging you all to stay motivated as you enter your high school careers next year. However, with that being said, our big winner for the night, an incredibly talented individual and a leader in the classroom that I know is going to do great things, and it works out well because she is due to come up and speak to us anyway. Our class president and class valedictorian, Erin Morrow. Congratulations. We're going to miss you next year, Erin. All right, well, while you're standing, you might as well come on up and share your address with the class. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Erin Harrow.
This president's speech goes to my class, but you guys can listen. This year has been amazing. We've shared so many memories. As I look back at all the fun times we've had, I realized that we were learning things along the way. I asked each one of you to tell me a memory that happened to us that stood out. Andrew, you said your favorite memory, and I quote was, "roasting you fools." And that's okay, because we need a little humor in life to get through the hard times. Not to mention, it always makes us laugh. Brianna, you said your favorite memory, which was one of mine too, was the locker room disco party. I remember it like it was yesterday. Priscilla brought her disco speaker, and we wasted no time turning it on. I'm pretty sure the whole school heard us, but we didn't care. Brianna, we were learning to let go. Sometimes you need to relax so our brains don't go into overload. Daniel, you said yours was hanging out with squad. You guys are amazing people, and the conversations we have are just hilarious. But we didn't realize was that we were learning reliability. We were always there for each other. It's good to know I can count on you guys. David. Oh, David. You said your favorite memory was throwing pine cones at some girls while they were in the dugout. I didn't like this story, so I fought long and hard with you about it. I just didn't see how I could tie this into my speech. I didn't see how I could connect the dots. But after hours of thinking, I realized something. You're a friend that makes us think outside the box. So thanks for that. Evan, I think the whole class remembers your favorite memory. You said yours was when Coach Tomas yelled at Justin Olabi. To give some background on it, it was at gym time and it was our workout day. To Coach, everyone was slacking off, but he seemed to notice everyone still found the energy to dance. So at the end of class, Justin was still getting his groove thing on. So Coach yelled and said, Justin, if you can whip a nay-nay, you can do a push-up. At that time, a lot of us were mad. We didn't think it was a big deal, but Evan, you liked Coach even more. So you taught us optimism. Thanks. There's too many things in life that can go wrong for us to always be thinking negatively. Gabriel, basketball tournament was yours. Both girls and boys teams lost every single game. The girls' spirits began to sink. At one point, I asked myself why we even win. We can't even win a home game. But as I looked at the boys' team, they didn't seem to care. They knew they were working their hardest. Even when the guys were down by 20, you still hustled the whole way through. Gabriel, you taught us to never give up, even though the odds were stacked against us. So thanks. Mason, you said climbing the stairways to heaven in the capital of Topeka was your favorite memory. You said you were a little scared to climb those stairs, but I can't blame you because I was more than a little scared. For those who don't understand, these stairs seem to be suspended in the air without anything supporting it. I thought it was surely my last day on earth, but to see you and others climb those stairs, despite the fact that you were scared, taught me courageousness. Sometimes you have to step out of your comfort zone to accomplish something great. Morgan, yours was hunting Bigfoot in the high school wing after the science fair. Bree told me that you guys thought that you guys were Charlie's new angels, sliding across the floor, rolling on walls, and jumping stealthily from spot to spot. I hear that you're trying to summon Bigfoot with your calling, but he didn't seem to come. Instead, a little mistake happened, but I'll keep that between us.
What was it?
You guys were learning to explore all possibilities, and although you didn't find Bigfoot, with that sense of exploration, you can find almost anything. Priscilla, your favorite memory was being accepted into squad. Priscilla, we have loved you since day one. How could we not? You're just a bundle of joy. Although you received acceptance, we received something we didn't have before, and that was you. Victoria, you said yours was the fundraisers that we had, from the bake sale to Valentine's Day to standing outside a Price Chopper. Victoria, you're amazing to work with, and honestly, if it weren't for you and your mom, we would have had class trip right here at home. You taught us leadership. We need people like you to control, otherwise the world would be a hot mess. Yahida, you said your favorite memory was going to harvesters to bag carrots. It's pretty funny trying to find the biggest and ugliest carrots. A lot of those were definitely ugly, or so I thought, but all I heard Yahida was say, "Aw, that's cute." Yahida, you taught us to see the beauty in all things, and although I still can't figure out how those carrots were beautiful, I've begun to see life in a different light. Did I miss anybody? Okay. My favorite memory was scary at first, but it ended up being good. It is also a reference to Priscilla's tribute. We were cleaning up after hot lunch on our Monday hot lunch when I realized my retainer was missing. I placed it in a napkin on my phone, which I knew I wasn't supposed to do. At that instant, I began to freak out. Morgan and Brianna and Priscilla were already taking the trash out. I ran out the kitchen screaming for them to come back. I rummaged to the top of the trash, then I realized I had to go deeper. By this time, Morgan, Brianna, and Priscilla were helping me rummage through the soggy pasta and green beans, half-eaten bread, and don't forget the brownie sundaes with all the ice cream, whipped cream, and cheese. And on that day, we threw away everything because we just had too much.
Finally, after a few minutes of looking, God answered my prayers, and I found it. After that, I realized the true meaning of friendship. I couldn't let these girls go. You guys are amazing. We are truly squad girls. Thanks, girls. Class of 2020, God has blessed us with amazing gifts. Let's use them.
I've gone to school here at Midland for 9 years. That being the case, I've seen many staff members come and go. The Midland staff has a variety of great people working, but one in particular stands out to my class and I. Ever since I was a little kindergartner, Mr. Brazil has always gone out of his way to make sure someone said hi to me or to make sure that I got over to the bus. He cleans up all our messes and sings while doing it. He goes out of his way to make Midland a better place for everyone. This man is truly selfless and hardworking. The Bible tells us that we should strive to be like Jesus in everything we do. We should set on an example like Jesus did. Mr. Brazil reminds me of Jesus. He's selfless, merciful, kind, and caring. He sets an example of Christ every day. I hope one of my classmates and I I hope all of my classmates and I can be just like him. This is why we chose him for our speaker. Come on up, Mr. Brazil.
I think she said it all. We can just go home now. Well, when they came to me and asked me, I said, you know what? Is this the same class that had gotten in trouble with me the year before? You know, me and the parents here have something in common. We both clean up after them. This is a great group of kids. I'm going to tell you, young adults, I shouldn't even say kids, young adults. I've had the pleasure of being able to drive them on these basketball trips and stuff like that. I've come up with nicknames, okay? And I asked each one, most of them anyway, if I could say this up here, and they agreed that it would be okay. But as I was watching these basketball games, these volleyball games and stuff like that, my mom had a habit when I was a kid of giving us the nickname of someone we were reminded her of. And so Gabby, I call him Gabby the Navigator, correct? Okay, because in a basketball game, he has this uncanny ability to just go around everyone, dribbling in every which way, and since I can't even dribble, that was quite impressive. Now, Erin, I'm going to pick on Erin a little bit. She's leaving, and I just don't like that at all. Okay, Erin and Morgan have rode the bus the most in the last few years. And we get into these conversations when I'm driving. And these conversations usually have to do with Midland, teachers, or this or that. And once in a while I've had to diffuse a few things. But it has been fun. It's been exciting. She has shown me that she's a very deep thinker. And then her closer sister follows right up behind and hits it home. And I can attribute that to Mom and Dad because I've met them in a few games myself. But I will miss you, and I sure wish you would go. If there's anything I can do to change your mind, let me know. I'm playing the bathroom twice. Andrew Helmer, this guy has impressed me. I mean, I was at a game, and I think Gabby was sick. So, you know, everybody was having to work extra hard. And Andrew just was in these people's faces. I mean, they couldn't get away from him. Every time he was defending, I mean, they were bumping noses, you know? And so I came up with the nickname, Andrew In Your Face Helmer. Priscilla Josiah, in the hallway, every day, she always beats me to say, hello, how are you? And I just think that's something special, because I try to always be the first to do that. Matter of fact, I might even say that 10 times a day to you if I keep seeing you. But that's special. Daniel Hickman. Daniel and the Heart of Jesus Hickman. All right. Daniel has got a soft heart. Daniel acts tough and jokey, but he's got a very soft heart. And I surely appreciate that about Daniel. Brianna. Okay, Brianna loves to ride the tractor with her dad, or did, love to ride the tractor with her dad when he would mow the field. And I used to sit out there on the bus, and I'd be looking out through there, and she'd be sitting between his legs, and that tractor would be bouncing, and she'd be bouncing, her hair would be blowing, and she'd just have this great big smile on her face. So I got her as Brianna, I love to ride the tractor Nelson. I don't have a nickname for everybody. Just a few that I've really talked to have been around. But Evan Croft, at the basketball games, you know, he was serious. You know, he always had to look like, not only am I going to take the ball from you, but I'm going to dribble around you in the process. Okay, so I called him Evan the Man Croft. Victoria. Victoria, I gotta tell you, I have never seen anyone try so hard. She just, no matter how it came to her or what, she did her best. Not that they all didn't, but just, you could see it in her face. And matter of fact, I just sat with her dad quite a bit and talked about it, and he goes, well, she sure does try. That's what she does. So Victoria, I'm trying my heart out, Shelby. Morgan Wickheiser. Okay, now this is what I understand to be the softball girl who plays basketball. So, and I've watched her throw the ball at these games, and I'm the kind of guy that if it was coming that fast at my face, I'd run. Okay, or I'd turn, I'd do something. So it's Morgan, I throw hard, Wickheiser. Can we bow for a word of prayer? Father God, please bless this speech. Lord, please help that it sinks in, that it has your words in it, Lord. Lord, I love you, and I thank you for all that you do for this school, for this class, and for these parents and grandparents and siblings. In Jesus' name, amen. I was looking at the aim. We will risk going too far, and only then will we discover how far we can go. Wow. Now that's something right there. I mean, you're going to go that far and just to see how far you can go. So I thought about these questions. How far can you go? Where does the road end? And how will you get there? And there's the motto, by having 20/20 vision for the future. Well, I think that 20/20 vision is going to have to include a few things. First, it's going to have to include Jesus. Jesus was asking questions up right up until he died, before he was resurrected. Jesus was a teacher beyond teachers. No wonder he was the Messiah. You're going to have maturity. This maturity thing, this is where I came up with the trouble that we had on the bus ride. We went out to the music